Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video, guys, I'm gonna show you fill to cap the way how I'm doing it on a 6-inch carbon pipe. This is the final product. This is how it's gonna look like, and I'm gonna show you the steps how to get to that point. So this is CAD 40. I already did the hot pass. I was using 120 amps 7S6 filler wire. This is hot pass. I always like to go a little bit wide with my hot pass, so I'm usually 1/8 or T32, depends from the root inside if you got a really nice good solid root. But before that, please guys, subscribe and like on this channel. Make sure click that bell icon so you stay up to date and get all the notification about my content. So before that, I'm just gonna go for the fill pass. It's gonna be two passes, one fill pass and one fill to flash. Stick out up to 10 mil, 1/8 tungsten, cup size 8. And the amps I'm using for this is 140 amps. And as I said, 7S6 1/8 wire. So for the fill pass, you wanna create a little bit good build up, have lots of meat, so you got not so much left to fill to flash. Even though if it's CAD 40, still got to do two passes. The whole idea of fill to flash is you got good preparation for your cap, for your final pass, for your cover pass. I'm gonna do a two pass cap on this one. As I said, 140 amps 7S6, that's the beauty of that filler wire. Really melts really nice. You got really good control, nice and clean. The whole idea, even though if it's TIG, if it's clean, still you're gonna have some TIG slag inside. Also depends from the material. Even if pipe is clean in and out, you're still gonna get some impurities. It's gonna just retract inside your weld puddle, and you're gonna have like oilish on the top of your puddle. As you can see here, this is a TIG slag. That's why it's good wire wheel or just a wire hand brush and clean after each pass. Same thing, up to 10 mil. Now I'm gonna fill to flash. The whole idea is go up to that edges inside the bevel, make it flush with the surface on the top of the material. It's gonna be way easier for your cap. Cap is gonna look really nice. So this is the gap we gotta fill. Same amperage for this pass, 140. As I said, the whole idea is make sure to stretch both sides. Don't pass that edge. Just stay inside. Make sure you're keep that rod in the middle. And you push as needed. And you can see the amount that actually you need inside to make it fill to flush, to make it flat. You don't want to have any buildups. That's why good amperage, good settings, nice and clean equipment. And that's it pretty much. This is for, this is fill to flush. Always clean your pass, each pass. That's it. That's exactly what I want. There's no gap inside. And now it's gonna be easier to lay those beads. As I said, it's gonna be two passes. I'm just gonna go cover that 50% of that existing weld, and go maybe two mils on the side. The whole idea with a good cap, it's your consistency, and that's how you can tell about your control, and that's how you're gonna have nice and straight bead, and that's what you want exactly. But before that, a little bit about TIG sleeve. Hey guys, let me introduce you to TIG sleeve. This is TIG rod storage tube, a special design for TIG welders. Every unit is handcrafted, features an O-ring seal to protect your TIG rods from moisture, dust, and any damage. 37 inches in length, So it's gonna fit full size dig rods, weighing just 2.6 pounds with a 10 pound rod capacity. Strap it over your back to stay mobile and hands free while you're climbing. Crawling comes in 5 different colors and you can check it out on tigsleeve.com. Don't forget, it's free shipping for US and Canada, and you can always show some love with supporting this channel by purchasing one of those TIG tubes. So for the first pass, as I said, I'm covering almost 70% of that weld on the bottom. Go 2 mil maybe on the side and try to maintain the straight line. As I said, it tells a lot about your control. This is how you're gonna get a nice and straight bead, which in the end is gonna look really good. Proper buildup amperage I'm using for this, 145 for 1/8 filler wire. This is how you're gonna get a nice and good buildup while maintaining your control. And you can tell by the edge, this is pretty much how you judge someone's weld. You want to see how good control he got over his puddle, and this is what gives that good look when it's nice and uniform. And that's exactly that edge what I'm talking about. Now for this, it's gonna be, I'm just gonna finish this one pass on the other side. Same idea. You just start, when you start on the bottom, or even if you in roll out, just start and just follow that edge. It doesn't matter the middle, it's not so important. Like the first pass, it's always that side on a pipe. You want to have a nice and straight line. Middle, as I said, it's not so important. You can always have uneven edges, as the second pass is gonna cover all that. Okay, that's it for the first pass. Still that TIG slag on the top. You can always use a buffing wheel or remove that. I'm not worried much about that. This is just for educational purposes, guys. There's no x-ray here or nothing. So for the second pass, same thing. I'll go around the 50% overlap with that first pass. And now with the second pass, because it's a final pass, you gotta take care of both edges and both sides. You wanna have a nice straight edge. This is what you want to practice. If you're not good at it, take your time when you're doing cap. If you're happy, QC will be happy. But also depends about your standards as well. Right? If you're happy, my QC might not be happy. That's why you gotta raise the standards. And the cap is the best way to do it. Takes patience and good focus and control. Hey, and helps you later with root and with other stuff that's related for welding. And that's it. 2-pass cap. It's at around 50% I overlap with that first pass, and this is how it should look like. It's not the best, I don't have the best welding machine. It'll be a little bit better if I got Miller or something else, but it's still good. Still good, it'll do the work. Okay guys, same thing again, subscribe and like if you like this video. Don't forget to click that bell icon button so you stay up to date with all my content, and thanks for watching and see you in the next one, guys.